Hey everyone, this is Wild Bill for America. Thank you for watching. Today I've been thinking about what America would have been like if we'd have had political correctness back in 1942 when we were fighting Nazi Germany. Well, think about it. President Roosevelt would have made speeches about how Nazism is all about peace, but has been hijacked by a few extremists. And how about America's first Nazi congressman? He would have been sworn in with his hand on Mein Kampf rather than the Bible. And I'm sure the New York Times would have written about how America is getting what it deserves because of the way we treated the American Indian. American universities would have warmly welcomed Nazi speakers, and any student who complained would have been suspended for being a hate monger. The Jewish studies programs would have been stacked with Nazi sympathizers, and the emphasis on the studies would have been what the Jews have done to cause Nazi violence. And to demonstrate that we didn't hate Nazis, we would have had them doing security at our airports. America's public schools would have been scrambling to find Nazi speakers to visit the schools and talk about how wonderful Nazi life is to the students. And the students would have had a special day where they would have dressed like Nazis and got to practice the Nazi salute while exploring Nazi literature. Oh, and political correctness also would have helped our military because they would have had chaplains of the Nazi persuasion counseling our military. Yeah, the foolishness of political correctness. We can only imagine what Hitler would have done with it. British Prime Minister Neville Chamberlain found out the hard way what political correctness is worth when he did the politically correct groveling act at Hitler's feet and then came home waving that piece of paper promising that Hitler wanted peace. Well, within months, England was fighting for its very existence against the brutally vicious Nazi armies. So was Hitler impressed with the political correctness of Chamberlain? Well, after meeting with Chamberlain, Hitler sent a letter to his army saying, "Our enemies are like small worms." Small worms. That's how dictators see the politically correct. And I couldn't agree more. The World War II generation would have never tolerated such foolishness, and we shouldn't either. It's time to stamp out the foolishness of political correctness before it stamps out our entire country. This is Wild Bill for America. Thank you for watching. Please pass this video on to both your friends and your enemies, and God bless America again.